2 Peter 1:10. Wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fail. All praises and glory goes to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and elders of Yasharala, and salutation to the Akim throughout the four corners of the earth, preaching the truth in sincerity, and keeping the faith of Yahweh Shai in the gospel. This is Yahweh Ya'ala. Just, you know, going into a lesson, you know, just concerning, you know, being diligent in our calling. And basically, you know, this is just something that's been on my mind, just about, you know, making sure that we're staying, you know, one track focus, you know, focus on really, you know, pushing this truth out as much as possible and getting out of Babylon. And, you know, one of the things that, you know, I noticed is that, you know, whenever you're staying, you know, focused on doing this work, then it makes it a lot easier for you to, for us as servants to overcome, you know, the works of the flesh, basically being able to, you know, stay within the spirit, you know, so that way the flesh doesn't overtake us. And what is, you know, the things of the flesh, basically, you know, the things of this world, all right? Basically, you know, being lazy, being worldly, you know, getting into a mind state of not wanting to basically better yourself, all right? And the more and more you implement, put your mind into these scriptures, put your mind into doing the work, whatever it is, you know, different brothers, you know, might, you know, be heavy into reading, you know, prayer, you know, basically, you know, meditation. Brothers do administrative work, maybe uploading videos, whatever it is. Some brothers upload, you know, their own videos and sit downs as well. And basically, when you're in that mindset, it's very hard for, you know, basically your mind to drift away into that area, because your mindset is a one track focus. And the thing about it is the simplicity of the gospel is noted in here. You know, as Yahweh Shai said, you know, learn of him, you know, for his burden is light and his yoke is easy. All right. And the Most High has in the last days created various ways for brothers to, you know, to either learn, you know, the word, whether it's, you know, a brother can listen to an audio Bible, a brother can listen to some sit downs, you can read a book. All right. You got apps as well. All right. There's ways you can, brothers can communicate with each other, whether it's, you know, on a group chat, through an app, or whether it's texting one another, calling one another. So there's ways that we can basically survive within this brotherhood just in the last days and being able to really, you know, do this work. And the thing about it is, you know, in this current world that we're in, all right, there's many distractions, you know, and basically, you know, we want to find ways to eliminate as many of those distractions as possible. Especially as we're approaching the last few seconds of this place going down, okay? And, you know, wanted to make sure that brothers, you know, stay diligent and don't get complacent. You know, don't let the complacency get to you. You know, it's very easy for it to get to us when we feel like you're already at the finish line. You know, but the thing about it, when you're getting closer and closer to that finish line, that's when you're really going to be putting in, you know, getting into that extra gear. That's where you're going to give it your all right? And we're basically at the end of this race, and this is where you're really gonna make your, you know, make your money, so to speak, okay? Earn your reward. It's really went in that last and final, you know, sprint to the finish line, okay? All right? This is Luke chapter 12, verse 37, all right? Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching. Verily I say unto you, that he shall gird himself and make them to sit down to meat, and will come forth and serve them. And if he shall come on the second watch, or come in the third watch, and find them so, blessed are those servants. And this know, that if the good man of the house had watched what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not have suffered his house to be broken through. Be ye therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when ye think not. Then Peter said unto him, Lord, speak thou this parable unto us, or even to all. Okay, so basically, you know, you see here, you know, that there's a first, a second, and a third watch. So we're talking about even before, you know, Yahweh Shai shows up, he's already is watching on what brothers is doing. Okay, so on the first watch, he didn't show up. He basically, you know, on the second watch, he didn't show up either. Okay, But on the third watch, he came and he found them so doing, and he said, blessed are those servants. So there is a time period of which we're doing the work, you know, spiritually, where the Most High is going to be watching to see, you know, basically what we're doing, you know, and if we're basically still being diligent, you know, if someone is basically, you know, still have their mind in this, you know, brothers is doing whatever they can. You know, I know even just talking about from our camp alone, you know, brothers have different schedules, but brothers have found a way to still do the work, to still go out and teach as well, you know, so they're not making an excuse. They're finding the time to actually get the work done, okay? And, you know, that's basically the importance of this thing, man, is basically, you know, having that fear, man. You know, you really got to have that fear of that you have to be out, you know, week in and week out, that you have to be doing the work, you know, whenever you can. Of course, you know, certain situations come up where a brother might not be able to do the work and be able to come out on certain days. But that's where a brother has to say, okay, look, what can I do to be useful? Can I basically, you know, prepare something for the brothers to use, you know, when they go out there? Can I prepare, you know, maybe some precepts or something like that? A brother can basically send out different articles that brothers can go into when they go to camp or whatever. Whatever it is that a brother can do to basically still be on his watch and still be basically, you know, being doing the work in one form or fashion, okay? So, you know, and go further down, you know, just to kind of see what it says. It says, and the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household to give them their portion of meat in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his Lord, when he cometh, shall find so doing. Of a truth, I say unto you that he will make him ruler over all that he hath. Okay, and that's basically part of being, you know, joint heirs. Okay, because basically, you know, Yahweh Shai has been given from Yahweh, right? Basically, the entire universe, not just the earth, but the entire universe. Okay, so we're talking about being able to be joint heirs and rulership with Yahweh Shai. It's really a lot bigger than a lot of brothers think. You know, we got to start thinking on a higher level of what this is that you're really laboring for, because a lot of times a brother might not know what he's truly laboring for, you know, in this walk of ours, and miss sight of what kind of reward this is. You know, that goes back to the man that purchased the field. Okay, he understood the value, and that's why he reacted the way he did. Sometimes if a brother doesn't have the proper understanding of why he's doing this, first of all, one, you know, we're doing it because of the fact that it's our duty to do this. We're unprofitable servants, first and foremost. Every man's gonna receive every man a penny, which basically that's good enough for everybody just to receive eternal life. But we also do this basically because we're obedient. We understand what Yahweh Shai did for us and what, you know, our Heavenly Father basically, you know, did for us by putting up his only begotten son up on the cross to die for, you know, our sins, okay? And basically being able to be humble and doing this work, because that's what he would do. This is what he's required for us to do, and it's the least that we can do, okay? All right, so, you know, basically, it's just, you know, exhortation, you know, just on staying diligent, all right? John 6:27, labor not for the meat which perisheth, but for that meat which endureth unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you, for him hath God the Father sealed, okay? So we're going to labor for this meat that perisheth not, you know. Sometimes, you know, a brother might have overtime, you know, at the plantation. Sometimes it might not be profitable for a brother to probably work overtime. I know, you know, just speaking for, you know, myself, sometimes, you know, it's not profitable just because you want to make sure that you're doing the work. Sometimes you say, look, I can't do that many days, and then basically find yourself not being able to, you know, do the work, find yourself being tired, and then you're not able to study. Because you got to understand, we're still in this flesh. So someone's pushing himself to the limit to where he can't, you know, do what's required of him to do this work. Yeah, before you know it, you're going to be sleeping. You're not going to be reading as much. You're not going to be throwing up your prayers as much. And then that's when Satan just comes in and tries to, you know, start throwing, you know, counter punches at you, you know, because now you've been slacking. You basically haven't been keeping your guard up, you know, in this thing, okay? That the labor not for the meat that perish, but for the meat that endureth unto everlasting life. And how do you do that? You got to remain diligent, okay? Now, going into Luke 19:11, and as they heard these things, he added and spake a parable, because he was nigh to Jerusalem, because they thought that the kingdom of God should appear immediately appear. And he said, therefore, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for him a kingdom and to return. And he said, called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, occupy till I come. Okay. So basically that's what we're doing. We're being occupied, you know, occupy, you know, the word there, you think about occupation. Occupation is a work. When you're occupied in something, this means you're tied up into it, you know. And then even when brothers is not doing the work, they're preoccupied, all right? And that's good to have. If you're preoccupied in your mind of doing, being occupied, that's a good thing, you know? And brothers always talk about all the time. You know, if you're at the plantation, you know, we know that's not the real work, but you might be at the plantation, you're thinking about, you know, what you're going to do, what you're going to read, what you're going to go into, you know, thinking about, you know, going to camp, all right, the following Saturday. All right, or thinking about, you know, basically class or whatever it is, and you're preoccupied with your occupation, all right? You're thinking about it all the time, and then when it comes, you're willingly doing the work because it's something that you've been anticipating to doing. So we're gonna occupy to he comes, all right? We're the body of Yahweh Shai. So as a body of Yahweh Shai, we would do as Yahweh Shai would do, which is basically do the work. And anybody who doesn't have that mindset, if you're basically don't have that mindset, you are lukewarm. Because if you're hot in your mind, this work is going to be preoccupied in your mind, and it's going to be easy for you to occupy till he comes. But for those that is not occupied in their mind, it's going to be harder for someone to do the work, to do the things, to basically build themselves up. All right, basically build themselves up and build up that inner man, and basically work on their weaknesses. Then they're going to basically be that, you know, lukewarm. And the Most High is going to spew them out, okay? So, just kind of want to finish this off. You know, 1 Corinthians 15 and 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Yahweh Shah Mashiach, okay? So, you know, basically, it's a very simple thing. You know, be steadfast, be unmovable, be always abounding in the work. All right, always growing, always increasing. You know, always basically, you know, on top of your game. You know, sharpening yourself, you know. Don't be like these other camps, these other men where they basically learn a couple of things, put some fringes on, and they think they're doing the work just saying that's right. You know, if you're a brother that's newer in the faith, you know, take, you know, basically, you need to just get that milk and grow. You know, the Most High is dealing with brothers, you know, that are full age and brothers that are newborn, okay? But if you're a brother that's basically been in this thing for a long time, you've been in this thing for years, you know your thing, you know, do whatever you can to increase, you know, what you're doing, you know? Take things out of your life, you know, that's basically, you know, hindering you from being able to maximize yourself, man, because really, this is it right here, man. This is the last incarnation. We're not going to have another reincarnation. This is it. You know, this is really it. I mean, and it's getting to the point where we know this is really it, to the point where all hell's about to break loose very soon. All right. World War III is pretty much happening right now. All right. So basically, continue to push this word. Continue to remain diligent to make your calling and election sure. All right. We're almost out of here, Akim. So, you know, again, want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and elders of Yasharala, and salutation to the Akim throughout the four corners of the earth, preaching his truth and sincerity, and keeping the faith of Yahweh Shai in the gospel. Shalom.